enhance our friendship. A friendship which is more than 65 years now. We have such strong bonds and ties, and what we are looking for is to see how we are enhancing further this relationship to the best interest of both countries. We are a member state of the European Union. We can play our own role, as India was playing this role for us, since the Cyprus question has arrived. They are keeping a principled stand on the Cyprus question, and we are grateful to them. We have excellent relations not only on the international forum, but as well as in a lot of other fields, especially our own interest is to see whether we can get out of the know-how and excellent progress in technology, research, invention, we are going to see how to, through bilateral agreements and so on, how to get the advantage India is having to these fields. But bearing in mind that India is so advanced in technology and research, the very first thing I'm going to ask is whether there are people who are interested to help us with their own, with their knowledge and their the know-how, and how to help us in, we have an area where we are planning to build up a technological park for like the Silicon Valley or similar parks which are in existence in India, and so it is the very first. But the most important is that Cyprus, in spite the size of, and of course it is not Cyprus money, it's Cypriot money, they are the eighth
largest
FDI investor in India. So there are a lot of other, is the tourism sector, services sector, cultural education. There are so many fields we can, the trade, of course.
Education.
Education, yes. To bear in mind, in spite of our size, we are the eighth bigger investor in India. Not from our own money, I have to admit, but from all those companies who are using us, they are based in Cyprus. Therefore, we are looking forward, and our tax treaty will encourage much more companies to invest in India who are having their base in Cyprus, and so we are looking to see how to enlarge our economic ties as well. And not only the economic ties, it's the tourism, as I told you before, education, culture, technology, which is most important, and all other fields where we can have a better and closer cooperation. As I mentioned before, we can play our own role in the European Union, being the ambassador of, let's say, India within Europe. We know that the free trade agreement is under negotiations, so we can play our own role in favor of India, because we consider that India is one of the most reliable partners, and therefore I'm looking forward to this visit, and I do believe that it's going to be one of the most important visits I have ever during my tenure in office to a foreign country. We have to work together. We have to honor the our principles and values, and to see how to cooperate together in order to overcome the problems. And I do believe that we can do so. And we eventually are going to be successful in spite of problems, because if we shall change our policies, concentrating much more on the societies, on the youths, to be much more sensitive on the problems the European citizens are facing. Because what's happening nowadays, there are people, or the peoples of the various member states, they are talking about a bureaucracy, Brussels, that there is no sensitive connection with the communities or the peoples. So we have to change our policies to be much more sensitive in the problems that our citizens are facing. The social policy should change. And I do believe that we should, by doing so, we shall bring back the trust towards the European Union project.
So you see an altered European Union emerging, maybe requiring changes in the manner in which the Union functions?
Yes, definitely. Otherwise, the risks are going to be increased.
They have never influence the Indian government to change their principal stand on the Cyprus question. Therefore, we are not asking our friends not to have any kind of relations. To the contrary, those who are closely connected with Turkey, they can give a hand give a bigger help or strongest help in our efforts. Therefore, it is not. But let's concentrate on the specific questions you have put. It is too early to predict how President Erdogan might behave as regards the Cyprus question. Yeah. At the same time, of course, we shall ask Prime Minister Modi if he has any or any kind of possibility to intervene. Is going to be very welcome. We know that from the moment the principal stand on the Cyprus question is there, and the Indian government is supporting a solution on the basis of the UN resolutions and all these kind of instruments, international instruments, I mean. Not only we are worrying about, to the contrary, it's going to be very welcome, an initiative by the Indian government. But if they think that